Okay, my topic is Bottled Water by me, Abigail Gross. Okay, so 50 billion plastic water bottles were used last year, and only 23% were actually recycled. This means that 38 billion water bottles, more than $1 billion worth of plastic, was wasted and ended up in landfills. My position is that the effects and costs of bottled water outmeasure the benefits. Bottled water benefits, according to the opposition. A lot of people think that bottled water is healthier. Okay. So in defense of bottled water, Thomas Laria writes that 68% of those 20 years old or older are classified as overweight and obese. Bottled water is a healthier choice when tap water is not accessible, preferred, or convenient. This is true in regards to the fact that water fountains are so spread out and not able to be found in like a given area. It's kind of hard to find them sometimes. If bottled water were not available, people would settle for soda, thus contributing to the unhealthy habits and the potential for obesity. It is convenient and easy to get to. A study conducted in Australia and New Zealand showed that when asked to give a reason for why people drank bottled water, 21% of the people asked said convenience. It's much easier to simply go to a store and buy a bottle of water than it is to carry around a bulky refillable bottle and try to find a water fountain that might not be guaranteed to be there. Okay, and the last reason is that underdeveloped countries can benefit from the bottles. So, Tom Standage writes that more than 1 billion people lack reliable access to safe drinking water, and about 80% of all illnesses are due to waterborne diseases. An argument for an alternative to this would be to, instead of get rid of the water bottles entirely, we just send them over to these underdeveloped countries and they can drink that instead, and that'll get rid of some of the diseases. Okay, so the first reason as to why the effects and costs of bottled water outmeasure the benefits is because of the carcinogens and contaminants that have been found in water. According to Natural Resource of Defense Council, a third of bottled water brands violated state or industry standards in at least one sample of these contaminants, such as fecal coliform bacteria, E. coli, and arsenic. These contaminants in large doses can not only make people violently ill, but can actually kill some people too. Tap water is most likely cleaner than bottled water. According to Lauren Tarshis, it's likely that the water flowing from your tap has been more thoroughly tested than what you are guzzling from a bottle. That's because cities are required to regularly test tap water to make sure it doesn't contain dangerous germs or chemicals or contaminants. Bottled water companies don't have to do that as rigorously. Lastly, certain conditions cause chemicals to leach into the water. Okay, so the University of Florida and Institute of Food and Agricultural Sciences showed that water bottles, when exposed to extreme heat or cold, release the chemicals antimony and bisphenol A, or BPA. These contaminants cause negative effects on children, and the chemical antimony is considered a carcinogen by the International Agency for Research on Cancer. Okay, bottled water production wastes oil. According to Zoe Cormier, the Pacific Institute in the U.S. has calculated that each year, Americans buy 29 billion bottles of water, which use up 17 million barrels of oil. Think about it. 17 million barrels of oil just to drink from a little bottle that probably will last maybe 5 or 6 minutes and will end up in either the trash or on the ground. We could save those 17 million gallons of oil by just drinking tap water. Okay, so the leading producers of ethylene, which is the main raw feedstock for PET plastic and is derived from crude oils, are Exxon, Shell, British Petroleum, and Dow Chemical. Richard Gerard, a researcher at Polaris Institute, writes that terephthalic acid, one of PET's two primary raw materials, is produced using paraxylene, which is derived from crude oils. It also uses monomethylene glycol, or MEG, which is another primary raw material that is also derived from crude oils. Once the PTA and MEG are combined, they create polyethylene terephthalate, or PET. Our crude oils are being wasted in order to produce plastic bottles that end up in landfills more often than not, and our oil reserves are suffering because of this.